Around 800 before century, there was an ancient town in current day of Iraq called Nineveh. People of Nineveh had immoral ways of life and had turned away from Allah. The booming city of Nineveh had long forgotten the message of Allah and became a city filled with idol worshipping and sin. Thus, Allah decided to send Prophet Yunus, or in English, referred to Jonah, a man born amongst them, as a messenger to guide them to his path, which is the path of light. As the messenger of Allah, Prophet Yunus immediately set out to fulfill his Lord's wish and invited his people to turn to Allah and shun idol worship. However, the people of Nineveh rejected Prophet Yunus, just as many nations rejected the prophets and messengers before him. Yunus was not deterred. He continued to call them to the worship of Allah, reminding them of the terrible wrath of Allah that was directed at the Ad and Tsamud tribes, and also the people of Nuh. But they rejected this and said, "We and our forefathers have worshipped this God for many years, and no harm has come to us." Prophet Yunus wanted to help them and was persistent. He did not give up on his people, despite their ignorance and harsh words. He continued to warn them of Allah's punishment. "Let it happen." The men laughed and informed Yunus that they were not the least afraid of his empty threats. Prophet Yunus was disheartened. He gave up on his people. Without the permission of Allah, he decided to leave the city of Nineveh in hopes of finding a community far away that will accept him and enter the fold of Islam.
Then, Prophet Yunus received notice that the people of Nineveh were going to be destroyed in 3 days, to which the Prophet Yunus despaired and left the city of Nineveh. Nevertheless, Prophet Yunus had clearly abandoned the people of Nineveh. He boarded a small passenger ship with the intention of travelling as far away from his people as possible. The ship travelled through the calm waters during the day, but as the night closed in, a storm raged on, rocking the ship wildly. The crew and passengers began to fear for their lives as the seawater gradually began flooding into the deck, slowly sinking the ship. As the tempest continued through the night, the captain of ship ordered his men to throw out the luggages and all other excess load overboard to lighten the ship's load. As instructed, the crew threw out the ship's excess load, but the ship continued to sink as it was still too heavy. The captain was left with no choice. He had to sacrifice the life of one man if he wished to save the lives of his crew and passengers. As it was a common practice among men during those times, the captain decided to draw lots to choose the passenger to be sacrificed. The lots were cast, and Prophet Yunus' name was selected. The men knew that Yunus was a young, righteous, honest and blessed man, so they refused to throw him out and agreed to draw lots again. So, the lots were cast for another time, and Yunus' names appeared again. The men refused to throw Prophet Yunus. They say, "We are not going to get rid of Yunus. He is our blessing on the boat. He is the best man we have on the boat. We are not going to get rid of him." Then, they threw lots for the third time, and Prophet Yunus' name appeared yet again. The men were baffled, but Prophet Yunus knew that this was the verdict of Allah, for he had left his people without his Lord's consent. So, Yunus jumped out of the ship into the dark, angry waves in the middle of the ocean.
Without anyone's knowledge, Allah had commanded the largest whale in the ocean to swallow Prophet Yunus just as it hit the water. Prophet Yunus was unconscious, awoke to find himself enveloped by sheer darkness. He believed he was in his grave, but as he sent awakened, He realized that he was not in his grave, but was in fact in the stomach of a large fish. Deep in the stomach of the whale, Prophet Yunus prostrated to Allah and said, "Oh Allah, I am prostrating to you in a place where no one has prostrated to you before, in the stomach of a fish." He then called out to Allah, repeating, "None has the right to be worshipped but you. Glorified be you. Truly, I have been among the wrongdoers." The creatures of deep sea heard the invocation of Prophet Yunus and gathered around the whale to join along in the celebration of the praise of Allah. Allah, the most merciful, was immensely moved by Prophet Yunus' repentance. He commanded the whale to spit out his messenger at the nearest shore. The whales obeyed Allah's command, who then swam to the nearest shore and ejected Prophet Yunus. Prophet Yunus' body was inflamed because of the acid in the whale's stomach. He had no protection against the sun and the wind. So, Allah commanded a tree to grow over Prophet Yunus to provide him with food and shade. Allah forgave him and informed him that if it were not for his sincere invocation, Prophet Yunus would continue to be in the stomach of the whale till the day of judgment. When Prophet Yunus was completely recovered, he traveled back to the Nineveh to complete his mission. Upon arriving at his hometown, Prophet Yunus was stunned. The entire population of Nineveh has accepted Islam and were awaiting his arrival. Together with his people, Prophet Yunus prostrated to his Lord and thanked him for all his blessing.
Yunus was the only prophet whose entire community accepted Islam as their religion. Allah stated in the Holy Quran regarding the people of Yunus Ibn Matta, "Was there any town, community that believed after seeing the punishment and its faith at the moment save it from the punishment?" The answer is none, except the people of Yunus. When they believe, we remove from them the torment of disgrace in the life of the present world and permitted them to enjoy for a while. From Surah Yunus, verse 98. But what sin that Yunus committed? Is it wrong to give up on his people?
The answer is yes. Let's take a look back at what happened when Prophet Yunus left Nineveh. The Prophet Yunus thought the people of Nineveh were destroyed, but that did not happen. After he left, the people of Nineveh noticed the skies darkening and became terrified. One of the followers of the Prophet Yunus convinced them to go to the seashore, beg Allah for forgiveness and plead with Allah not to curse them. Moved by this display of sincere repentance, Allah lifted his punishment, forgave his subjects and showered his blessings upon them. As the skies cleared, the people prayed for the safe return of their beloved Prophet Yunus so that he could guide them through the path of Allah.
The sin of Prophet Yunus was despair. After being told by God that they had 3 days before being destroyed, it was not Prophet Yunus' right to give up on his people. At the last second, one of his followers that had remained behind made all the difference. Prophet Yunus' sin was so grave, he had to go through an excruciatingly painful experience. However, Allah is Al-Ghafar. Allah is the great forgiver. Allah forgives the sins when his servant repented.